YouTube, welcome to Dr. Vibes Learning Point. This is the part 3 out of the 4 modules of Anesthesia Crash Course. In this part of the Anesthesia Crash Course, we will be studying about CPCR and the ACLS protocol. Very important from MCQ point of view and more important in your real life. So what does CPCR stand for? It stands for Cardiac Pulmonary Cerebral Resuscitation. Earlier it was only called as CPR and you might have heard about that. But recently, one more C, that is cerebral component, has been added. Now, when do you do CPCR? You do it when the patient is in cardiac arrest. Now, what is cardiac arrest? Cardiac arrest is the inability of the heart to generate the cardiac output. Now, cardiac arrest can be of two types. When electrical activity is present, when electrical activity is absent. But what is common? That the heart is unable to generate a cardiac output. Now, there are two conditions in which electrical activity is present and the patient is in cardiac arrest. One is ventricular fibrillation and the other is pulseless electrical activity. And the second condition, when the electrical activity is also absent and the patient is unable to generate a cardiac output, is the asystole. So basically, you have to remember ventricular fibrillation, pulseless electrical activity, and asystole. Now, one more thing is there, that this ventricular fibrillation is a shockable rhythm. Just for now, understand that it is a shockable rhythm. What is shockable rhythm and what is the significance of that, I will tell you later. And the pulseless electrical activity and the asystole are non-shockable rhythm, correct? Now, what is the sequence of CPCR? You might have heard from everyone, or you might have heard as general knowledge also, that A, B, C, D, E, these are the 5 components of CPCR. But the sequence is C, A, B. That means first, it is the cardiac activity that you have to take care of, then is the airway, and then is the breathing. And cardiac activity, C basically means the compressions that we give. I will tell you about this in detail in a few minutes. Now, हमें CPR CPCR देना तो स्टार्ट कर दिया जब हमने देखा कि कार्डियक अरेस्ट हो गया पेशेंट को, पर कब तक CPCR देना है? So the end point of CPCR is the return of spontaneous circulation, which is called as ROSC, return of spontaneous circulation. And how will you measure this? You will measure this by palpating the carotid artery. If you can feel the pulse in the carotid artery, that means your CPCR is successful and you can stop that. Now, there are basically two types of CPCR. That is, there are two methods by which you can revive a patient from cardiac arrest. One is the BLS, that is the basic life support, and the second is the ACLS, that is advanced cardiac life support. Now, the main and the primary difference is that BLS can be given by any common individual on any setting, be it road, hospital, any shop, anywhere. But ACLS is given by trained individuals, skilled people, and only in the hospital setting. Okay? Now, the components of BLS and ACLS, because these are the part of the CPCR, is the same. That means airway, breathing, circulation, drugs, and exposure. These 5 components dono mein hi common rahega. Andar mein difference aata hai. Like airway. Let's begin with airway. In BLS, the airway management is done manually. क्योंकि मैंने क्या बोला कि वो हम कहीं भी कर सकते हैं, कोई भी कर सकता है. So it is done manually. Basically, you have to head lift, you have to tilt the head of the patient, you have to lift the chin of the patient and give a jaw thrust. क्या करोगे? Head को tilt करो, chin को lift करो, jaw thrust दो. But in ACLS, what is done? This is done using an equipment, and this equipment is called as Udall's airway, right? Now come to breathing. BLS में हम mouth to mouth breathing देते हैं या maximum bag to mask ventilation देते हैं. But ACLS में this is done using a laryngeal mask airway (LMA), endotracheal tube or tracheostomy tube. Now come to circulation. For circulation, both of them have a common thing which is called as cardiac massage. I will discuss about the cardiac massage in details in a short while. The fourth component is the defibrillation. In BLS, the defibrillation is done with the help of automatic external defibrillator, and in case of ACLS, a manual defibrillator is used. Lastly, the drugs. In BLS, no drug is given. Common sense, you can't give a drug in a shop or a station or any road, but you can give drugs if the patient is admitted in the hospital. So what are the drugs that is given? Basically, adrenaline is given, 1:10,000 dilution, and this is given in IV excess. Okay, now we will discuss about the cardiac massage, that is the most important component of the CPCR. So basically, cardiac massage, you have to give the compressions, the chest compressions. You might have seen this in various videos where people or trainees are giving CPCR to revive the patient. So exactly that, chest compressions, is only the cardiac massage. But how to give that, when to give, how many to give, that is important, and we will discuss that. So first, basically, you have to check the pulse of the patient. If it is an infant, you check the brachial pulse. If it is a child, that means more than 1 year of age till 18 years, you check the brachial or the carotid pulse. But for adults, you always have to check the carotid pulse. Now, where will you give the compression? Compress to karna hai, lekin compression dena kahan pe hai? In case of infants, you give it in the lower 1/3 of the sternum. And in case of child and adults also, just locate where the sternum is. The lower 1/3 of the sternum is your area where you have to give the chest compression. Because just lower 1/3 of the sternum ki hi peeche mein aapka heart hota hai, and hame heart ko hi revive karna hai. Now, how will you give the compressions? Infant में अगर आपने दोनों fingers या दोनों hands से दे दोगे तो बहुत ज़्यादा pressure चला जाएगा, तो infant में इतना देते नहीं है. You have to give the chest compression to the infant only with the help of 2 to 3 fingers. In case of child, give it using one hand. But in case of adult, you have to use the 2 hands to give the chest compression. What is the compression rate? एक मिनट में आपको 100 से 120 chest compressions देने हैं. So the chest compression rate is 100 to 120 chest compressions per minute. What is the depth of the chest compression? कितना नीचे तक हम लोगों को अपनी hand को compress करना है? 1 inch in case of infants, 1.5 inch in case of child, and if you are reviving an adult, 2 inches have to be given. Now, very important thing, just chest compressions देने से नहीं होता है. Chest compression के साथ ventilation, क्योंकि हम लोगों को airway और breathing को भी revive करना है. So chest compression is to ventilation ratio is very important. Now, here there is two things that you have to remember. First is you are giving chest compressions, ventilation without any advanced airway or with any advanced airway. Now, what does advanced airway mean? Advanced airway means ventilation. So, aap वेंटिलेशन दो तरीके तीन तरीके से दे सकते हो, एक माउथ टू माउथ वेंटिलेशन, एक बैग मास्क वेंटिलेशन और एक वेंटिलेटर की मदद से वेंटिलेशन. नाउ द माउथ टू माउथ वेंटिलेशन एंड द बैग एंड मास्क वेंटिलेशन इज कंसीडर्ड एज अ नॉन एडवांस्ड काइंड ऑफ एयरवे, एंड जस्ट इफ यू आर यूजिंग अ वेंटिलेटर दैट इज कॉल्ड एज एडवांस्ड काइंड ऑफ एयरवे. सो हियर आर द टू कैटेगरीज. नाउ इफ यू आर जस्ट गिविंग अ नॉन एडवांस्ड एयरवे वेंटिलेशन, यू हैव टू सी वेदर इट इज अ सिंगल रेस्क्यूअर और टू रेस्क्यूअर्स. मतलब आप एक सिंगल पर्सन हो जो उस पेशेंट को बचाने गए हो, या आपके साथ दो आप लोग दो इंडिविजुअल्स हो. सो इफ यू आर अ सिंगल रेस्क्यूअर, यू हैव टू गिव 30 चेस्ट कंप्रेशंस, मतलब 30 बार चेस्ट कंप्रेशंस दो, दो बार वेंटिलेशन दो. ये तीनों के केस में होता है, इन्फेंट में भी, चिल्ड्रन में भी एंड एडल्ट्स में भी. बट इफ यू आर टू रेस्क्यूअर्स, देन इन केस ऑफ इन्फेंट यू गिव 15 कंप्रेशंस एंड टू टाइम्स वेंटिलेशन, बट दिस रेशियो रिमेन्स द सेम इन केस ऑफ चाइल्ड एंड एडल्ट. इन केस ऑफ चाइल्ड एंड एडल्ट इट इज ऑलवेज 30:2, मतलब 30 कंप्रेशंस दो बार वेंटिलेशन दो, 30 कंप्रेशंस दो बार वेंटिलेशन दो, इफ यू आर डूइंग अ नॉन एडवांस्ड एयरवे अलोंग विद चेस्ट कंप्रेशंस. बट if you have an advanced airway, that means you have a ventilator with you, then you will give 100 to 120 chest compressions per minute, as you already know, for compression rate. For ventilation rate you have to give 20 to 30 breaths per minute in case of infant or child, but in case of adult you have to give only 10 breaths per minute. Now this is the overall thing that you have to know before you actually go on to study the ACLS protocol. The ACLS protocol, ACLS as I told you stands for advanced care life support. So you see that a patient is in cardiac arrest, matlab uska heart koi output generate nahi kar pa raha hai. First of all what you will do BLS, because you don't have the equipments or the hospital setting. Sabse pehle you will start the BLS. What will you tell the patient? Are you okay? Are you okay? If the patient is not okay, then you have to start the ACLS protocol. Okay? What? How does it start? You have to first call for help. आपको देखना पड़ेगा आजू बाजू में कोई है कि नहीं, इसको call करके बुलाओ. You have to activate the emergency response alert. Okay? So call for help any person and activate the emergency response alert. Then you have to check the pulse of the patient and the breaths of the patient. Pulse कहाँ check करोगे? Already discussed. In case of infant, you check the brachial pulse. In case of child, you can check both the brachial and the carotid pulse. But in case of adults, you have to check the carotid pulse. Pulse check किया आपने? Breaths check करोगे. Breaths कैसे check करोगे? Stethoscope लोगे? डायरेक्टली लंग्स एरिया में पुट कर दोगे. या आप देखोगे कि इज द पेशेंट ब्रीदिंग. ओके, नाउ रिमेंबर दैट दिस पल्स हैज टू बी चेक फॉर 5 टू 10 सेकंड्स. ओके, नाउ इफ यू सी दैट पल्स नहीं है पेशेंट का, ब्रेथ भी नहीं है पेशेंट का, दैट मींस द पेशेंट हैज गॉन इनटू कार्डियक अरेस्ट, वी विल बिगिन सीपीसीआर इमीडिएटली. नाउ देयर आर टू थिंग्स इन सीपीसीआर दैट यू हैव टू ऑलवेज रिमेंबर, दैट वेंटिलेशन पेशेंट का चलना ही चाहिए. आइदर डू इट माउथ टू माउथ, आइदर डू इट बैक टू मास्क वेंटिलेशन और वेंटिलेटर्स, ये कंटिन्यूसली चलना ही पड़ेगा. एंड सेकंड थिंग, यू हैव टू कीप मॉनिटरिंग द पेशेंट. व्हाट डज मॉनिटरिंग द पेशेंट मींस? यू हैव टू कीप चेकिंग द पल्स, बीपी, respiratory rate, etc. And also there should be a defibrillator along with you. So these three things must be there with the CPCR. Continuous monitoring of the patient, ventilation of the patient, either in the form of ventilation or oxygenation, and the defibrillator. Now you have to see, is the rhythm shockable? Just few minutes ago I was telling you that there is a significance to that the rhythm is shockable or not, because ACLS protocol change jata hai. What did I say you? I told you ventricular fibrillation is a shockable rhythm, but pulseless electrical activity and all systole are non-shockable rhythms. So you have to check if the rhythm is shockable or not. If the rhythm is shockable, that means you are dealing with ventricular fibrillation or the pulseless ventricular tachycardia. So if it is shockable rhythm, matlab patient shock dene se revive karega, to patient ko shock do, you give shock 1. After giving the shock 1, you give a high quality CPR. What does high quality CPR mean? High quality means you have to give 5 cycles of CPR in 2 minutes. 5 cycles of CPR in 2 minutes. Also start with the IV access. Agar adrenaline de sak rahe ho, to phir dena shuru karo. After doing these two things, that is shock 1 and high quality CPR and IV access, you again check. Is the rhythm shockable? If the rhythm is shockable, you give shock 2. Again, high quality CPR and IV access adrenaline. If the rhythm is not shockable, then that is a separate component. I will come to it in few minutes. Now, you have given shock 2, you have given high quality CPR, you have given adrenaline. How much to give adrenaline? You have to give adrenaline 3 to 5 gram every, you have to give 1 milligram of adrenaline every 3 to 5 minutes. Every 3 to 5 minutes, you have to give 1 milligram of adrenaline. After doing this, you will check again, is the rhythm shockable or the rhythm is not shockable? If the rhythm is shockable, you have to give the shock 3. You have to give the shock 3. Along with high quality CPCR. Now, what is the difference between shock 1, shock 2, shock 3? As you are increasing the number of shock, you are also increasing the amount of energy that you are providing. So, aap zyada joule of energy provide kar rahe ho in shock 3. Ekdam bare minimum se shuru karo aur usko maximum tak leke jao. Theek hai? Even after giving shock 3, if you see that you are not being able to revive the patient, you start with amiodarone and you check for the reversible causes of cardiac arrest. Theek hai? So, amiodarone will basically check or look for the arrhythmia, if the patient has arrhythmia. इसलिए हम लोग amiodarone दे रहे हैं, 300 milligram दिया जाता है. You also along that, you will start checking the reversible causes of cardiac arrest. This is a very important question. What are the 10 reversible causes of cardiac arrest? So you remember this, there are 5H and 5T. What are the 5H? 5H is hypovolemia, hypoxia, H plus ion concentration ज़्यादा होना, मतलब acidosis, hypoglycemia and hypo and hyperkalemia. These are the 5H. What are the 5T? 5T is a tension pneumothorax, tamponade, toxins, thrombosis, pulmonary and thrombosis coronary. So what are the 5H? Hypoglycemia, hypohyperkalemia, hypoxia, hypovolemia, acidosis. And tension pneumothorax, torsades de pointis, toxins, thrombosis, these are the 5T. Okay. Now if you see, that the patient that the rhythm is not shockable. Okay, if the rhythm is not shockable, then you have to see, is there any sign of return of spontaneous circulation? If it is yes, that means the CPCR has been successful. You will do the post-CPCR rules and regulations. But if you see that no sign of spontaneous circulation is present, then you again have to give CPCR. Okay. Now, in the beginning only, if you have noticed or identified that this is a not shockable, this is not a shockable rhythm, मतलब shock देने का फायदा नहीं है, मतलब ये pulse electrical activity है या फिर ये asystole है. That means there is no role of shock. You just have to give CPCR and you have to start IV access. Check again, is the rhythm shockable? Is the rhythm not shockable? If it is not shockable, give CPCR, IV access. And also, CPCR देते देते you have to check if there is any sign of spontaneous circulation. मतलब carotid में आपको check करते रहना पड़ेगा कि pulse वापस आया कि नहीं, person breaths करना शुरू किया कि नहीं. So this is all about the ACLS protocol. In this, just after this, I will also discuss the monitoring in the anesthesia because this is somewhat related to the ACLS also.